The first tool that you need to learn to use in order to be proficient with DAX Studio is the metadata panel. The metadata panel gives you features like selecting the database on which you want to work to, look at the content of tables, columns, and different measures. And you can also look at all the functions which are available in DAX on your model or a specific DMV. You can search for objects, and there is also a right-click menu that proves to be extremely useful. Let's see all the features together. This DAX Studio is already connected with a model. Let's zoom in on the metadata panel. And from the first combo, I can choose the database to which I'm connected. On this instance, there are four databases, and I can choose the one that I want to work with. The second combo, let me choose the perspective. If my database contains multiple perspectives, I can choose the one that I see in the metadata panel from here. Then I have the list of all the tables, and under each table, I have the list of all the columns. If you hover on a column, you have some information that stays there for a few seconds. Indeed, it disappeared right now. It tells me that currency is a string. There are 28 distinct values. It gives you the minimum and the maximum value, and also the first 10 values of that column. This is useful whenever you work with a database that you have never seen and you want to have a quick preview of the content of a column in order to understand what is stored there. Each object has icons. You see, for example, the date has this small blue circle, which indicates that date has been marked as a date table. This is an important information to know when you look at DAX code, so DAX Studio gives you the information immediately in the metadata panel. There is this small lens that activates search, so you can search for example, amount, and the metadata panel is now filter showing only the column names or measure name that contain amount somewhere. If you right-click on a measure, you have several features. We are going to see them in detail later. It's just good to know that the right-click does something there. And the right-click is obviously different depending on the object on which you click. If you right-click on a table, you have features specific for a table, and if you click on a column, you have features which are specific for that column. The last thing that I want to show you about the metadata panel is the bottom of it. You see that we have metadata, functions, and DMV. So far, we just look at metadata, but you also have functions and DMV. Functions enable the list of all the DAX functions which are supported by the database to which I'm connected to. Because DAX Studio can connect to different versions, it queries the database asking for all the features which are available, and so the functions that you see here are only the ones supported by your database. And it also provides some information about the syntax. You see, for add columns, it tells you that add columns requires a table, and then a list of name and expression to create its result. Finally, at the bottom, we have the DMV. DMV are kind of technical, so you do not use DMV all the time. So DMV are special kind of queries which can be executed against a server to gather specific information. And if you want to run a DMV, you just double-click on it, and DAX Studio copies a select statement in the query that you can immediately run to see the result of the DMV. I'm not going to explain you all the details of what DMVs are and what they do. It's important only to know that the DMV can be executed from inside DAX Studio, and you have the list available here in the metadata panel.